What's good, kings and queens? Hope everyone's staying well hydrated and cool during this miserable summer. So since I was pretty much the only channel to make a video that did this man justice, showing off his skills back in the day, and my boxing skills series video titled The 48-0 WBC Champion No One Talks About back in 2018. I spent years gathering material on this guy, and if it wasn't for that series, I finally found a reason to spotlight him on my platform, in which that has always been the goal of my page, is to promote Asian boxing, which is not talked about much, and put a spotlight on the lower weight classes while having fun and talking about boxing as a whole. So since I'm no longer able to have that video on YouTube, I decided to make another video talking about the career of Chayapon Muntsi, aka Wanheng Menayothin. So back in the old 2012-2014, when your boy and Gorilla Productions was dishing out highlight videos and promos, I would often go on BoxRec and go through random countries' highest ranked fighters. Though they were not at that time ranked the highest, it caught my eye and I bookmarked the page till later I found out there's a watch feature if you have an account with BoxRec to keep track of these fighters. Those two fighters happened to be Sisakit Rungvisai and Wanheng Menayothin of Thailand. Wanheng at that time was a WBC international champion of the strawweight division. So that was my introduction to Wanheng. Like many great pro Thai boxers, Wanheng was originally a Muay Thai practitioner before transitioning to boxing. From what I've seen over the years, Muay Thai kickboxers and kickboxers in general can easily make that transition to boxing opposed to boxers transitioning to kickboxing. You can go back and watch Shannon Briggs' interview about his very brief time trying out K1. Wanheng started his Muay Thai career and flourished, becoming the Lupini champion and Thai national champion, finishing his Muay Thai career with 150 fights on his resume. Wanheng went pro in 2007 at the age of 21 years old. He wasn't as active as I would have imagined compared to other Thai fighters. He started his debut with 5 fights and it trickled down to 2 by 2010. I'm guessing it was mainly due to him waiting to get a shot for the interim international title, which there was some silly hiccups happening, not on his end, from progressing further. So finally, after 2 defenses of an interim international title, not the actual title, Wanheng had the chance to fight for the WBC international silver title against Jason Rotoni, in which he easily won. Wanheng at this time in 2011 is ranked number 6 by the WBC and number 6 by Ring Magazine. Strawweight was very stacked in 2010 through 2011. Kazuto Ioka, Akira Yaegashi, Moise Fuentes, Denver Coelho, Heki Butler, Katsunari Takayama, and Roman Gonzalez, who was an absolute monster at strawweight. So the waiting list for Wanheng was pretty ridiculous here. Dude should have went with the IBF, since his track record fighting mandatories has been quite well. By the time Wanheng was able to fight for the title, all that talent had already moved up. He went on to fight newly crowned WBC champion Oswaldo Novoa of Mexico. And this is where a lot of people who paid attention to the lower weight classes finally got to see him, and he did not disappoint. Wanheng finally becomes a champion, which that's already a hell of an accomplishment. A legitimate Muay Thai champion, and now a legitimate belt holder in boxing. In between his first title fight and him waiting around, Wanheng ranked in 23 fights in a 3-year span, sitting on a clean 35-0 record. As mentioned in my previous video discussing the best fighters in every weight class, Wanheng has one of the best jabs and defenses in boxing. He's a 12-round type of fighter, so don't expect him to be looking for the KO unless it's obvious he can finish the guy off. He definitely took some notes down from Floyd in that category. For the boxing purists, it's something you can truly appreciate. Wanheng made defense after defense, becoming one of the WBC's most active champions, possibly the most active, especially since he was fighting his mandatory opponents, making 12 title defenses. (laughs) Shortly after the time when Wanheng became the WBC champion, another Thai fighter by the name of Knockout CP Freshmart became the WBA champion and rose up through the ranks to the number 2 spot while Wanheng was ranked at number 1. Every great fighter has that opponent to define their career. Unfortunately, when Wanheng came on the scene, those guys left. CP Knockout Freshmart was that guy. This would have been a historic bout, first of its kind. WBC, WBA, and lineal strawweight unification between two Thai fighters who were former Muay Thai champions. It's very sad this matchup did not happen. There are many reasons to why, but whatever is true or not true, I can say as a boxing fan, this was a huge blow to the promotion of Thai boxing and eliminating bad stereotypes of Thai fighters that have plagued them for years. My opinion, Wanheng would have easily won, and that win alone would have further legitimized his perfect record that is forever going to linger around because he surpassed Floyd's record. People will be like, well, Floyd unified weight class after weight class and became the lineal champion. On paper, Wanheng has the record, but the West will always give it to Floyd and discredit what's on paper. It's like whenever HBO brought up the undefeated champions record list, and whenever Lampley would have to talk about Sven Otaki, he really had nothing positive to say and immediately goes out of his way discrediting his accomplishment of retiring as an undefeated clean sheet champion. A clean sheet is when you have no imperfections on your record. Draws, no contests, whatever, that is not a W. It's a small list of champions that achieved this. Despite all of that, Wanheng had completely fulfilled his duties as a title holder. He did not find a way to not fight his mandatories, like a very particular person who somehow was able to achieve that for 5 years. I don't know how that goes under the radar, but okay. And for that, Wanheng is an incredibly underrated WBC champion. Now, one of the questions that may be asked in this video is, why didn't he ever move up? Wanheng is undersized and the smallest weight class in boxing. When he was fighting in Muay Thai, the size disadvantage seemed to be even worse in his favor. I don't see him moving up. If it does happen, it really has to be against the right opponent, that is a champion, to give him that credential as a two-division champion. He is currently 34 years old. Despite him backing out of his shortly lived retirement, I don't really see him fighting much after that. 2 to 3 fights tops. Fighters in the lower weight classes really seem to fall off after the 30s, with a few exceptions. With Wanheng announcing he will be fighting again, the question is, will he unify strawweight? Will he remain undefeated? Stay tuned. And on top of that, for more videos like these, be sure to like, share, and if you're new, subscribe. Follow me on Instagram for more video updates, memes, boxing news, whatever. I'm Alphys Honcho, and I'm out.